Today's topic is mind, body and speech. Mind is marvelous. Where is need of changing anything? The mind is changing anyhow all the time. Look at your mind disappointedly. This is enough to calm it. When it is quiet, you can go beyond it. Do not keep it busy all the time. Stop it and just be. If you give it rest, it will settle down and recover its purity and strength. Constant thinking makes it decay. So the mind has a lot of power. Mind also, human mind is developed mind. It is a blessing to have it. And at the same time, it is cursed to have it, because it can lead you towards the wrong path. And it is blessing because it can make you grow spiritually. You have to know how to use it properly. That's what you need to know. Mind is very powerful. Then speech. Speech, by saying good words, you can make all the people your friends. By saying bad words, you can make the whole world your enemy. So you have a very powerful instrument with you. Either you make friends or you do make the whole world enemy. It is up to you. Speech is very, very powerful. And body. Of course, body. Human body is the greatest instrument in the whole world. Without human body, it is very difficult to realize the God, the superpower, or whatever it is, the highest power. What people say, God, or whatever the name they give it. Without body, human body especially, you cannot realize it. Maybe it is hidden inside of you, inside your body even. That's why the Indian ancient saints and rishis and munis, they discover that there are 7 chakras in the body, and if they work properly, you can reach to the godhood. Maybe it is hidden inside of you. So instead of thinking about your mind and speech, just think about your body first. Your body is the temple of living God. Yes, your body is the temple of living God. God lives here. But you have to make it pure, this body. Don't put in it garbage. Eat properly. Eat well. Don't eat like animal eats. They just attack on the food. No, you have to eat very nicely, beautifully, chew it properly. If you will not chew your food, then your intestines will work hard and you will die soon. So don't let your intestines work. Your teeth supposed to work first. Chew it very well. So the body remains very healthy and pure and divine. And that is the biggest instrument. That's what I put stress first on body, not on mind. Because your body is born first, not your mind. Mind developed later. So the people who claim that you have to control your mind, they are wrong. I will suggest just watch your body first. Because your first instrument is your body, not mind. Mind develops later. A baby is born with the purest body, divine body, but he develops or she develops mind later. So work on your body. Mahavira was right. Jain Tirthankar, Mahavira was right. He said, Kayot Sarga, first think about your body and make it pure and make it under your control. Don't let it be your owner. You have to be its owner. So whatever body needs, it will crave. If body needs salty things, it will crave salt. Sweet things, it will crave sweet. If it feels hungry, it will tell you. But don't eat, just mechanically. No. Otherwise, this instrument will be very difficult to remain in good health. So it is better just be always watchful about your body. Body, mind, and then speech. So put those forces together. You will create a wonderful world in front of you. And you can reach the highest state of consciousness. Highest state of consciousness. But you have to put them together. Let them work together. You have three beautiful instruments. First, beautiful instrument, body. Then speech. And then mind. If you work properly these three instruments, you can conquer the whole world. You can be the top of the world. Just know how to put them together. Even you are praying, you chanting any mantra, are you saying any good words? Just remain there fully.